Welcome to part four of this six-part daily series, Wendy Williams Health, breaking down the illnesses. Please stop what you're doing. Go ahead and subscribe to my channel and hit that notification bell so you'll be among the first to know when I release new videos. I'm Dr. Frita. I'm a triple board certified medical doctor. I am not Wendy Williams' doctor, and I do not have any more access to her medical information than the rest of the world. But I do know a thing or two about medicine, and so we'll be breaking down some of her illnesses. Today in part four, I'm answering the question, what is aphasia? Make sure you check out the other parts of this series if you have not already. For part one, we talked about lymphedema, Wendy Williams' feet. Wendy Williams' team announced that she has been diagnosed with dementia and aphasia. But what is aphasia? Aphasia is a disorder that is caused by damage to parts of the brain that control language. And this is usually in the left side of the brain for most people. Having a stroke is a very common cause of aphasia, but it can also be caused by brain tumors, infections like encephalitis, a gunshot wound. Aphasia can be caused by traumatic brain injury, like blows to the head, like a boxer who's constantly getting punched in the head, or a football player. You can also get a temporary aphasia if you have a mini stroke or a TIA, transient ischemic attack. But then there are some progressive brain disorders that can cause aphasia as well. Specifically, primary progressive aphasia, which is what Wendy's team says is her diagnosis. When a person has aphasia, it can affect their ability to read, to write, to understand language, and to speak language. And if you've been watching this docuseries, Where is Wendy Williams?, then you will note that Wendy, who is a language queen, is having some undeniable difficulty in expressing herself. This certainly could be consistent with aphasia or the primary progressive aphasia, PPA, that her team says she has. Now, there are some other brain disorders that could also affect speech, so be sure you watch part two of this series where I go into alcohol-induced dementia. A stroke occurs when there is a loss of proper blood supply to a portion of the brain. So it can either be due to an ischemic stroke where there's a blockage in cerebral vessels or blood vessels, causing death to brain tissue and neurons, or you can get a hemorrhagic stroke where there's a lot of bleeding, excess bleeding, but it's not giving you the proper blood flow to the section of the brain. Either way, if it damages that language center in the brain, specifically the left side in the frontal region, temporal, parietal region, it can lead to different types of aphasia. Be sure to watch my YouTube video, Warning Signs of a Stroke. Having a stroke is a common cause of aphasia, and there are two main types of aphasia: fluent aphasia and non-fluent aphasia. So for the fluent aphasia, the most common subtype of that is a Wernicke's aphasia, and this occurs due to damage in the temporal lobe of the brain. So patients with Wernicke's aphasia have a very fluent speech. They have no problem saying a lot of words. The issue is that a lot of times the words don't make sense to most people. They may make up words or put words together that don't really mean anything to most people. They may make a statement like, I'm going to Salamakumba over the corner, back yesterday, over the street. And so they're speaking a lot, they're saying things fluently, but it's difficult for people to understand them. And the thing about people with Wernicke's aphasia is that they oftentimes don't even realize that they're misspeaking or making up words. And so they're looking at you when they're talking and saying all these words, and you're looking at them not really understanding what they're saying, but they're not so much aware that they're not communicating in a way that is understandable to most. The other broad type of aphasia is a non-fluent aphasia, and Broca's aphasia fits into that subtype. Broca's aphasia occurs when there's damage typically to the frontal lobe of the brain, and patients have difficulty getting words out. So while a person with Broca's aphasia may understand and comprehend everything that you're saying, when it's time to get the words out, they may skip words or have trouble finding words or leave words out like is or the. For example, they might say pick brush when what they're trying to communicate is I'm going over there to pick up that brush. Or they might say walk dog when really what they want to communicate is I'm about to go out and walk this dog. Interestingly, Wendy Williams, I found in that docuseries, for a lot of times, as expressive as she is, she would be very short with people, use two or three word simple phrases. And it's difficult to know. Is it because she had some type of an issue expressing herself, some type of aphasia, or was she being shady and short with people? I don't know, but potentially that could be a sign of aphasia. Oh, another thing about the Broca's aphasia, because it affects that frontal lobe of the brain, oftentimes people who have had a stroke, for example, and they have the Broca's, sometimes they'll also have a weakness on the right side of the body. That's because the frontal lobe is also responsible for a lot of motor movement. Now, for these types of aphasia I'm mentioning that are caused by kind of sudden or traumatic injuries, oftentimes they can get better over time, even without treatment. But that's different than the primary progressive aphasia, which is slowly progressive and does not tend to get better over time. That's a major distinction. Aphasia is typically diagnosed by a history and physical. The doctor will give certain tests, and if the physician feels that there is potential aphasia, they'll refer you to a speech language pathologist, and brain imaging helps, like an MRI or a CT scan. Now, back to the primary progressive aphasia. For this type of aphasia, which again, Wendy Williams' team states that she has this, for this one, there's no sudden catastrophic event. It's just a progressive decline in language due to damage of the neurons in the language centers. So it can happen due to dementia, such as Alzheimer's dementia, and certainly due to frontotemporal dementia, which is a diagnosis that Wendy Williams' team also says that she has. Make sure you watch part 3 of this series where I went into frontotemporal dementia. Patients with primary progressive aphasia can, just like with all types of aphasia, have difficulty with language, difficulty reading, difficulty writing, difficulty understanding speech, difficulty speaking. But again, the difference is, unlike some of the other types of aphasia, time does not heal the primary progressive aphasia. It gets progressively worse with time, historically, which is interesting because if you watch the docuseries and you see towards the end the conversation that Wendy Williams has with her sister, Wanda picks up the phone, she talks to Wendy, and she comes back and she reports that her sister sounds like the old Wendy. Theoretically, if Wendy Williams actually does have the FTD, the frontal temporal dementia, and the primary progressive aphasia, I would not expect her to have a great improvement after months and months and months, right? I expect her to get progressively worse. But if indeed Wanda is correct and her sister sounds much better, much more lucid, then that would actually go towards more her perhaps having the diagnosis of alcohol-induced dementia, which, as we discussed in this series, can, in some cases, get better over time if you are abstinent from alcohol. I would love to see Wendy Williams get better. So, as far as the treatments, there's really no cure, but speech-language pathology can help, and sometimes it helps for patients to learn certain gestures. So when they can't find the words, to have certain gestures, certain forms of sign language to be able to communicate. Technology has given us certain speech generating devices. If you found this information to be helpful, please, please go ahead and hit that like button and be sure to subscribe to my channel, hit the notification bell so you can be here tomorrow when I talk about part 5 of this 6-part series, What is Graves' Disease? I thank you for watching. I'm Dr. Frita, and I'll see you tomorrow.